strategy called Strangle, and I will be discussing all the nuances, when to implement it, how you should implement it, and what are the adjustment techniques you have to do when you are implementing this strategy. Everyone says to be a successful options trader, you should have right knowledge, you should know the strategy and all those things. Let me tell you, to be a successful options trader, the first thing you should have is guts. You should have the guts and the conviction in your trade. The next thing what you should have is the power of money. Money indicator is a very important indicator. Many people have asked me, sir, what will be my loss? What will be my profit in this strategy and other things? I tell them, you make sure you give me unlimited supply of money. I will guarantee you in writing that you will not have a loss. Yes, that is my guarantee. But how many retailers do you think can afford unlimited money? As retailers, our money power is limited. Yes, some might have few crores, some might have few lakhs, some might have few thousands. So based on your money availability, you have to decide the trade and the adjustment strategy what you take. So before I continue, I will first explain what option strangle strategy is, and then I will be telling you how you have to do adjustment using a simulator. So let's go to my whiteboard. First, I will explain you what short strangle strategy is. So when you are executing a short strangle strategy, you identify a range and you hope that the market will stay in that range till expiry. So we will be implementing this in a weekly expiry. So in weekly expiry, we execute this trade on a Friday and we allow the trade to expire in the weekly expiry, that is on the coming Thursday. So you will have 5 days to take this trade. So you will have Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, provided there is no weekly holidays and other. So when you are executing this strategy, you have to sell options which are 300 away from the spot. So on Friday, let's say Nifty opens at, let's say, 15,000. So in the morning, within 10 o'clock, where the premiums will be good, you sell options which are 300 points away from this. So the 300 points away from this is 15,300, and on the lower side it is 14,700. So you will be selling 15,300 call and 14,700 put. So when you say do this, so I'll just consider this as 15,000. So here you will have 15,300 and here you will have 14,700. So as long as Nifty trades between this and this, you will be making a profit. If Nifty expires within this range, you will make wonderful profit. That profit, it depends on what is the premium you have collected, what is the VIX and other factors, but don't worry, you can blindly implement this. So on Friday in morning, identify the range and sell these options. You have to sell this one lot. Sell this one lot. So this is nothing but a short strike. Now markets are volatile. You can't expect markets to be in this range. So nowadays you have seen that Nifty intraday moves more than 400 points. So whenever in these cases, there is a high chance that you will have to do an adjustment. So the adjustment what we will be doing
is called a martingale strategy. This is a very famous casino strategy. The strategy, the other name of this strategy is called double till you win it. Okay. So here we have sold one lot and one lot. Now let's say Nifty came to 15,200 on Monday. There was a massive news and Nifty shot from 15,000 to 15,200. Now your entire strangle is in danger. So what you do, and at this point of time, your both the trades will be in a loss. So let's say you are in a loss of approximately 3,000 rupees. I'm just giving you a number. Sometimes it can be more than this, sometimes it can be less than this. There are some times where you will be in profit as well. If the India VIX falls drastically, then probably sometimes you may even end this trade in green. But most of the time you will be in a loss. Let's say you are in a loss of 3,000 rupees. What you do, you cut all the trades, you close them and you book the loss of 3,000 rupees. Then at 15,200, you initiate another strangle, short strangle. So now at 15,200, you will take, you will sell two options, which is 15,500 call, 14,900 put. Okay, but this time you will not be selling one lot, you will be doubling the quantity. So here we sold one lot, but here you will be selling two lots. Now you got another range where you will have another 300 points this side and 300 points that side. If Nifty manages to stay in this range, then you will not only recover the loss what you have done here, but you will end it in profit. I will show you that in the simulator. Okay. So this is theory. So first understand this, then I will be showing you that in practical, which is simulator. So this is how we do. Now let's say this is on a Monday. So this happened on Monday. On Tuesday, we went. On Tuesday, let's say Nifty went to 15,400. There was another gap up. Obviously, this trade will also be in loss. At that time, you booked the loss. So now you have booked a loss of 3,000 here. So here you will be booking another, let's say 3,000. So you have booked minus 6,000 total in the entire trade. You book the loss and at 15,400 you execute another short strike where you will be selling 15,700 call option and you will be selling 15,100 put option. But now you will be selling 4 times the quantity. So you will be selling 4 lots. Okay. So in this adjustment technique, as I told you, money is the key. As long as you are able to pump money, you will be able to make and come out in profit. But the problem is, in this, you can't keep on pumping money. And a person like this, this is the third leg. So in the first leg, you require 2 lakh. In the second time, you will be requiring 4 lakh. In the third leg, you will be requiring 8 lakh. If on Wednesday, if again there is a huge gap up, then you will be requiring 16 lakh. And again, if there is a gap up, then you will require 32 lakh. The problem is, the person who has 32 lakh on Thursday will not initiate one lot. Because we never know whether we will have to do this kind of adjustment. In the worst case, even if you take an average person, he will deploy 25% or 50% of his capital. So if he has 32 lakh, he will not be taking one lot. He will deploy 16 lakh, where he will be playing in 8 lots. Okay. But this is a wonderful adjustment technique, provided you have the funds to pump in. From my experience, what I have found is, most of the time, I will end in profit at this stage itself. Most of the time, not every time. There are times where even after doing this, I did not end in profit, and for that we did other adjustment techniques. So what I would suggest you is, initiate a short strangle on Friday with 300 points gap. If it goes wrong, do one level of adjustment. Okay. Even after that, if things don't go in your favor, there is no point in continuing, because you will have to pump in more money. In that case, take book the loss and exit the trade. So this is a wonderful technique which one can adapt. Now I will show you in simulator how these things work.
So here we have taken the 6th May expiry. Okay, because I did not take the recent expiry, because the last expiry happened on 12th, which was a Wednesday. So I want to take one entire week. So I took an expiry which was previous to that. So 6th May was an expiry. So if you are executing in this week, you will be taking trade on 30th April 2021. Okay. So I have, this is Define Edge's option simulator. So on 30th, we will see for 6th May expiry. So on 30th, Nifty was trading at 14,780, which is approximately 14,800 at 9:20 a.m. on morning, 30th April. So now when you are initiating a short strangle, so let me just go to paint. So you have, so you have 14,800. So we'll be taking 300 points away. So which is approximately 15,100. Okay, and then we have 14,500. Okay, it's nothing but plus and minus 300 points. Okay, so we will be selling a put of 14,500 and a call of 15,100. So let's go to this and see what was the premium of these two strikes. 15,100. Okay, so here 15,100 call was trading at 50 rupees. So we will sell that. And 14,500, which was at 95 rupees, we will be selling that. Okay. Now let's see what has happened to the payoff graph. So this is how the payoff graph will look like. So you can see that you have break-even points of 14,355 and 15,245. So if Nifty ranges between these two and expires between these two, on expiry, you will be making a profit of a max of 10,900, which is approximately 11,000 rupees. Okay, but this was on 30th. So let's see what happened on next day. So I clicked on this next day. So 30th was a Friday. First, second was Saturday, Sunday. Third was Monday. On third, you can see that Nifty gapped down and it came to 14,500. So from 14,800 on Friday morning to 14,500 on Monday morning. So now it is time for us to do an adjustment. So at this time, you can see that you are currently sitting in a loss of 2,546 rupees. It's okay, we will book the trade. Okay, so now the price, it was trading at, was 6 rupees and 173 rupees, where we will be booking the trade. So I'll just put it, whatever is the figure what we see here. Okay, so you can see that we have booked a loss of 2,546. Now Nifty spot is at 14,490, which is 14,500. Now we initiate another strike. So now 14, okay, let me just delete this. Okay, so now we have 14,500. And we will be selling another strangle, which is 14,800 call and 14,200 put. But this time the quantity will be double. Okay. So at this time, after exiting this trade, let's see what is the option chain. Okay. So now we will be selling 14,800 call and 14,200 put. 14,800 call will be sold, but double the quantity. The price is 22. We will add and 14,200 put. The price is 65.55. Okay. Okay. Let's see what has happened to the payoff graph. The payoff graph is loaded. So you can see now if Nifty ranges between 14,129 and 14,921, which is your break-even point, you will end in profit. In the best case, if it ranges between 14,200 and 14,850, you will be making a profit of 10,000 even after closing the previous trade in 2,500 loss. Including that, you will be making this profit. Okay, so you will be not only recovering your 2,500, but you will also end in profit. Okay. Now this happened on 3rd. So we have 3 more days, 4, 5 and 6. Let's see what happened to next day. Okay, next day Nifty opened at 14,750. Okay, whereas you can see that our break-even point is at 14,921. So since we have a huge gap, so we'll not be doing anything. We'll just go to the next day, which is the expiry day. So here you can see that Nifty has retraced and come back to 14,600, and at opening you are already sitting in a profit of 6,000 rupees. Okay, but by the end of the day, let's see what happened on 6th May. Where did Nifty close? 6th May is here. Yes, Nifty closed at 14,700, approximately 720. So Nifty has closed somewhere here and you would have made 10,600 rupees. For a capital of 4 lakh only. So for 4 lakh, if you are making a profit of 10,000 rupees, you are making approximately 2.5% on your capital, even when your first trade went wrong. Okay. But if your first trade had not gone wrong, you would have made approximately 10,000 rupees profit. But at that time, the capital deployed was 2 lakh, but you should consider capital as 4 lakh because the capital which you have not used is 2 lakh. So this is a wonderful trading which you can do. And let me tell you from my experience, I have not done more than one adjustment here is most of the trades. Okay, probably I would have done the third leg sometimes, but I don't remember going beyond third leg. That's because this is not the only adjustment method what I do. There are other adjustment techniques which I will discuss in subsequent videos. So do like, share and follow my channel so that you can learn a lot about options trading and investment. Thank you for watching.